Hello guys, this is Hank, and today I'm gonna tell you the story that I had with this weird Demutant CPU from AliExpress. This CPU is so weird, so please follow the video until the end to find the full story behind it. And don't forget to subscribe and like the video so we can grow this channel more and more, and we can test more CPUs and do more videos. One day, I was shopping AliExpress and I found this very weird LGA 1151 CPU, and I contacted the company and asked for a review sample, and they were kind enough to send us a review sample all the way here to our studio. So thank you,
Shangdai and ShaKG Store,
for your help, and I wish the very best for your company. When I first received my CPU, I was very excited to try it and see what it's all about. It's a QNCT, which I talked about a lot in this channel, a 6-core 12-threaded chip with a 3.3 GHz boost, not overclockable unfortunately, but it's still a snappy deal for a $60 that it sold on AliExpress. So I got the CPU, then I got the Z270F Strix Asus Gaming, which I was super excited about because it took 2 months of shipping to arrive here. And then, when it arrived, I figured out I didn't order the tool that you flash the BIOS with. Then, I decided that I can manually flash it with an Arduino and a couple of wires. I hooked up the Arduino, and instead of hooking the board to the 3.3 volt line, I hooked it to the 5 volt line and I fried every single circuit in that board.
Was it fucking cool? Absolutely was fucking cool. Was it worth it? I'm not so sure.
Anyway, so I bought a new motherboard, a Z170 Mark I Sabertooth, which I got for a deal about 100 Bald Eagle dollars, which has a removable BIOS and made it easy for me to flash it with the custom BIOS that was sent by the seller. That was a part of the story. The RAM I got also for a deal on the used Facebook Marketplace for about $50 to $55, which is a 2666 ADATA XPG RAM with RGB and Aura Sync and all that shit. The best deal was the cooler, which is a dual tower, dual 140mm fans with 6 heat pipes and a plated base, which I got for around $35. It was a pretty much a steal for that price. Our CPU never got above 58 degrees maximum.
Damn, boy, he's thick, boy. That's a thick ass boy. Damn.
The hard disk I salvaged from my old PC, which is a 1 terabyte 7200 RPM disk. Also, the case was a knockoff case from Alexander Bays, which is a knockoff from Cooler Masters. It does the job for a pretty steal price of $60. 3 RGB fans with their controller, a tempered glass side panel, 4-inch front, and a USB 3 and Type-C ports. Last thing we got is the PSU, which is a standard CV550 from Corsair. 550 watt, bronze rated, the minimum for a solid build. I got it for a deal from my friend for $55. Now let's talk about the benchmarks. I did some games that I found suitable for this configuration without a graphic card. But if you want me to test more games, please tell me down in the comments. Also, consider subscribing to the channel and liking and sharing the video so more and more people can see this, and we can afford more CPUs to test and more graphics card and more tools to test in this channel. for a price of $80, it offers a solid performance, but it needs a bit of tinkering to get it to work. First of all, you need to have a specific motherboard. MSI board are very problematic with these CPUs, so the seller always recommend going with Gigabyte boards. Also, you need this flashing tool that I forgot and I had to wait 2 months to get this video out because of it. You need it in order to make the CPU run, because the seller need to provide you with a specific BIOS and you need to flash it into your board in order to get it to work. So a regular plug and play user won't be able to do this. You need a bit of tinkering and a bit of skills to get it to work. I don't advise getting the QNCT. I advise you getting the QQLT, which is a bit expensive, but it offers great clocks and overclocking capabilities. So I highly advise going the QQLT if you have a bit of money. But if you are constrained with your budget, you can get the QNCT and you will get great performance for the price. Also, Brian from TechYesCT did a video about it. You can check him out, link in the description. And that was it for today. I hope you liked the video. If you did, hit the red button and hit the like button. Share this video to help this channel out, because YouTube doesn't like small YouTubers. And see you in a new video. I gave you my heart.